సో ఐ టోల్డ్ ఎవర్ ఉపాసన నౌ ద టీచింగ్ స్టార్ట్స్ ఫ్రమ్ యమధర్మరాయ యమధర్మరాయ ఇస్ టీచింగ్ ది శ్లోక నంబర్ 18 to 25 శ్లోక 18 to 25 ఓకే సో ప్లీజ్డ్ విత్ నచికేత ద మోస్ట్ అవాల్డ్ డిసైపుల్ యమధర్మరాయ స్టార్ట్స్ టీచింగ్ వాట్ ఈ స్టార్ట్ టీచింగ్ ది శ్లోక న జాయతే మ్రియతే వా విపశ్చిత్ నాయం కుతశ్చిన్న బభూవ కశ్చిత్ అజో నిత్య శాశ్వతోయం పురాణో న హన్యతే హన్యమానే శరీరే సో దిస్ శ్లోక ఈస్ ఆల్సో అపేరింగ్ ఇన్ భగవద్గీత శ్రీకృష్ణ పరమాత్మ టేక్స్ ది శ్లోక ఆఫ్ కఠోపనిషత్ అండ్ టీచర్స్ ఇన్ భగవద్గీత బికాస్ భగవద్గీత ఈజ్ అ టీచింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఎసెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఉపనిషత్స్ సో హీ స్ట్రైట్ అవే టేక్స్ ది శ్లోక ఫ్రమ్ ఉపనిషత్ కఠోపనిషత్ న జాయతే మ్రియతే వా ది ఆత్మ ది సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ నైదర్ బోర్న్ నాట్ డై ఓకే ఇట్స్ నాన్ నాట్ బోర్న్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎనీబడి ది సెల్ఫ్ ఆత్మ ఈజ్ ఎటర్నల్ నిత్య శాశ్వత ఇట్స్ ఏన్షియంట్ యు డోంట్ నో వెన్ ఇట్ బిగిన్ పురాణ హన్యమానే శరీరే బాడీ డైస్ బట్ ది సెల్ఫ్ నెవర్ డైస్ ఓకే సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద టీచింగ్ ఆఫ్ యమధర్మరాయ టు నచికేత సేమ్ టీచింగ్ శ్రీకృష్ణ పరమాత్మ గివ్స్ ఇన్ భగవద్గీత టేకింగ్ ది శ్లోక దెర్ ఆర్ మెనీ శ్లోకాస్ ఇన్ కఠోపనిషత్ విచ్ ఆర్ టేకన్ స్ట్రేట్ అవే టు భగవద్గీత ఓకే సో యమధర్మరాయ ఈజ్ టెలింగ్ నచికేత ది నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ది సెల్ఫ్ రైట్ సో యూ డోంట్ యు నో యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ద లాట్ ఆఫ్ టీచింగ్స్ బిలీవ్ ఇన్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ విల్ సే ఆల్ మోటివేషనల్ టీచర్స్ రైట్ బిలీవ్ ఇన్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఓకే డోంట్ యు నో యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ది ఆన్సర్ ఈజ్ నో యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ ద డివైన్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ఫైనైట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ ఎటర్నల్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ అన్బోర్న్ అన్డయింగ్ I don't feel I am infinite. I feel I am limited. Your self is blissful. No, I am not blissful. I get only some little bit of bliss when I drink a cup of coffee or do something. I am not blissful. So, Yamadharmaraya is trying to remove the nature of ignorance of your self nature. Ignorance of self. This is called Atmadnana. Self-knowledge. Yamadharmaraya is giving knowledge of the self to Nachiketa. Okay, all of us have a real self and apparent self. Real self and apparent self. Real self is called Atma, which is eternal, which is immortal, which is blissful, which is always peace, which is never born. And we have an apparent self. That's called jiva, individual soul. A real self and an apparent self. We live with the understanding and illusion that I am the apparent self while ignoring the real self all the time. Not knowing the real self all the time. The master Yamadharmaraya is pointing out to you real self. Okay? So what is the problem of not knowing the real self? There was a beggar who spent 30 years of life begging on the beach, near a beach. So one day he dies. The people from municipality come and try to bury him and in the place where he is sitting. Suddenly, right, they dig a few feet deep. Suddenly they realize there's a pot of gold there. Must be somebody in the ancient time hidden a pot of gold there. So this beggar, if he had discovered that pot of gold, he would have been probably a millionaire or a billionaire. All the while he is sitting on the pot of gold, but still begging. We are like that beggars. We keep begging happiness. We keep begging peace in the world. We keep seeking happiness, seeking peace. All the while we are sitting or on infinite peace, infinite bliss, which is our nature. This is what is Yamadharmaraya teaching. Nachiketa. Now let us understand this little bit in more detail. Alright. So when you say I, okay, you use the word I many times a day. Okay. That meaning of I keeps changing. You see, I am walking. That means I is body. Okay. I am happy. That means I is mind. Okay. I am a doctor. That means I is profession. I am old man. That means you are a body. So the I is given a large number of meanings. Okay. And please notice carefully that these meanings are contextual, depends on the context. Walking is in the context of walking. The moment you are sleeping, that context I changes. Ask yourself, has your I changed any time? Has the I changed in your life? I was young, I was old, young boy, I was a little boy, I was a young man, I married, I am old now. That I never changes. So that means there is a changing component of I in ours and an unchanging component of I. Right? There is a changing component of I, unchanging component of I. Changing component of I is associated with body, mind, intellect and profession. Unchanging component of I is not associated with anything. It doesn't change. That unchanging component of I is called Atma. The Atma is not born. Atma doesn't die. Atma doesn't age with the body. When the body dies, nothing happens to Atma. In your own lifetime, you have seen from youth, from the childhood to youth to old age, the I never changes. The unchanging I is there and changing I is there. The unchanging I is eternal. Changing I is contextual. The context keeps changing. When you come in front of the husband, you become wife. When you go in front of the daughter, you become mother. Okay? The contextual I. So what happens is we confuse this changing context with the real I. So Yamadharmaraya is removing that confusion. He is pointing out, you are always the unchanging I which has no birth, no death. The spirituality is removal of our confusion. Spirituality is not getting something new. Okay? If you get something new, you lose it also. What has birth has a death. But what has no birth has no death. You will not lose it. The I has no birth, has no death. There's no bondage and there's no liberation. Only with the clarity you have to understand that unchanging I which is yourself. This is what is Yamadharmaraya is teaching to Nachiketa. And please understand, it has no death. That's why you don't have death. The death is for the context, which is related to body and mind. But Atma has no death. Okay. The body has death. Hanya mane sharire. Body has death. But the self, that you look at yourself. How do I know? Has your I changed at any point of time in life? No. But I is associated with the context. Oh, I am a woman. I am a husband. I am a wife. I am an employee. A contextually I is changing. Why are you confusing the changing context with the unchanging I? The changing context is called Jiva. Unchanging I is called you, right? So in other words, the me which has a body, mind, intellect and profession is called Jiva, and I, which is unchanging, is called Atma or the Self. So why are we confusing the Self with the context? Are we clear?